Upon leaving Nokmus's lodge, Anishinaabe headed west to the land of the Jigwek in search of his father. Each new day he awoke to a strange, beautiful song that traveled from the east. Knowing he needed to continue west, Anishinaabe was compelled to discover the source of this song. Camped on the western shore of a lake, he built a canoe and set out towards the rising sun. Paddling for many days, Anishinaabe finally reached the eastern shore, where he found a wigwam. To his surprise and excitement, inside was Firekeeper's daughter. Her beauty was overwhelming. Suddenly, the beautiful song stopped and she began to speak. She told Anishinaabe that she had been waiting for him and that she had prepared the lodge for the two of them. Anishinaabe realized that Creator had led him to this place and time, and that he and the Firekeeper's daughter were to be married. The union was the first of its kind on Mother Earth, complete and sacred in the eyes of Mamogosnan. Each fulfilled a role that complemented the other, providing a balanced life. This foundation would help guide future unions between men and women. From their union, four sons were born. All were raised with the teachings of Nokmus and the lessons learned from their father's journeys. Becoming men, each son was sent to one of the four directions. Each direction was guarded by a Squadam Nene, who taught the men important life lessons. Traveling north was Kiwaden. North is where Mother Earth is purified by snow. It is the land of bear power that holds the secrets to cure diseases. When this power is at full strength, the Wasnode can be seen. It is here that our medicine, Wishkpamishkos, can be found. Sweetgrass was the first plant to grow on Mother Earth, and its smoke keeps evil away. Traveling east was Waban. East is the source of all knowledge, and all should be attentive to what Mother Earth has to teach. Here you will find Sema. Smoke from this medicine is the visible thoughts and prayers used to communicate with Creator. Traveling to a warm land with mild winds was Jawano. Thick with forests and rivers, this is the land of birth and growth. Birds migrate here each winter, returning to and replenishing the four directions each spring with the seeds of life. Here our medicine Kishki grows, used to purify the body of disease and for protection from evil. Last to travel was Ningaben. Crossing huge mountains, he came to a land with no water, where the days were hot and the nights were cold. This is the land of the setting sun, and beyond it, powerful Minidok make their homes. Growing here is our medicine Wapshkobiak, used to purify the body and surroundings. Its smoke promotes good health. Their journeys complete, each son returned to the doorman of that region to marry each of their daughters. It is from these unions that Earth's first people originated.